So I just treated myself to a brand new MacBook M3 Pro, finally getting rid of my gaming laptop, and I want to consolidate my MacBook 2019 Intel Edition and my gaming laptop into one machine that can play games and emulate. So I'm looking forward to testing out the emulation capabilities of the MacBook and also testing out the new game porting toolkit and making a bunch of videos on how to do that. But one of the problems I have is that most of my hard drives are formatted to Windows. I used to have two hard drives, one that was FAT32 and one that was NTFS for my Windows machine. And the problem with having an NTFS hard drive and a completely MacBook system is that Mac cannot write to NTFS. So if I right click here, there's no option to add a new folder or anything like that. And if I was to just create a new folder here and try and drag that over to my hard drive, as you can see, there is a big stop sign, meaning that this drive isn't write capable. And if I check the get info section, you can see that it is formatted to Windows NTFS. Now, there are a couple of solutions. Some of them cost money and some of them don't. But if you do have a Western Digital hard drive or a Seagate hard drive, then you are in luck, because both of those drives come with a free version of Paragon's software, Paragon's Microsoft NTFS for Mac by Paragon, which usually costs around $20. Now, the downside to this is that it only works with your Western Digital or SanDisk or your Seagate hard drive, depending on what drivers that you use. I do recommend, if you don't have a Western Digital hard drive or a Seagate, to just pay the $20 for this software, because it is going to make your life a lot easier if you're running between Windows and Mac OS. Or if you're going to be strictly using your MacBook, then I just highly recommend using XFAT or FAT32. But because I use my hard drive also with my Xbox to play media and things like that, then I'm going to be needing to keep this one at NTFS. There is a software called Mounty for NTFS that is free, but that does come with a lot of drawbacks. One, with it being free, there is ways that you can like brick your hard drive from not being able to open using it and things like that. So I don't recommend using Mounty. It is a bit finicky to set up, and there are some drawbacks and things that you have to remember while using it. So the Paragon software one is the one that I recommend the most. But if you have a Western Digital or Seagate hard drive, then you don't have to pony up the $20. Now, I have a Western Digital one, so I'm gonna be clicking on that, but the install is pretty much the same. If you have a Seagate hard drive, you go to the link in the description down below, scroll down to the download section, and just download the latest driver there. With the Western Digital one, it's the same. You just go to the link in the description down below, find the latest driver, and click download, and it will download it to your downloads folder. Once the file's been downloaded, you just double click it to open the zip file, and it'll give you a DMG. Double click on that, and it'll open the virtual disk drive, and just click install NTFS for Mac. Now, you're going to get this warning, which is to install it is an app downloaded from the internet. This is just classic Apple gatekeeping on the apps. So you just want to click open, accept the software licensing agreement. You can read it if you want to, and then click next and input your password. And now we just wait. When you get the system extension blocked, open system settings and click enable system extensions. Then use your password or touch ID, and then click shut down. Because for some reason, I cannot disable the HDCP on my capture card right now, because ironically, I need a Windows machine, I'm gonna be doing it using my camera. So the first thing I'm gonna do is hold down the touch ID button to start up the computer after I click shut down. And then I'm gonna hold it until the startup recovery starts. So continue holding for startup options, and then loading startup options. So then I'm going to want to go to the options and click continue. And we're looking for startup security. So first I need to input my password for my user so that I can gain access to it. And it's put me into recovery, and I go to utilities in the top here and put startup, click startup security utility. Then when we go down, we click the Macintosh HD encrypted disk, which is the one that I use. Click unlock, type in my password again, and click unlock, and then click security policy. And then we want to click reduce security, and then click allow user management of kernel extensions from identified developers. And click OK. And then type in your password again. You should apply that security policy. And then after we've done that, shut down. And when we restart our computer, NTFS for Mac should be working. So next, when we load up, it is going to try to load new system extensions signed by Paragon Software, and we can enable these in system settings, so we need to provide consent. So open system settings and click allow. Use your password or touch ID. Now you should just click restart. The only reason I click not now is so I can pause this recording. Now another thing you're gonna have to do as well is also give it full disk access. So if you click on the bottom right corner and you see the NTFS Mac, or just open it from your applications, it's gonna ask you to grant full disk access to NFTS format. So click get started, click open in system settings, and just this bit here, granted full disk access. Then once you're finished, make sure you can check the login items pane. So click open login items, it'll tell you all the available items that will load up in the background during login. Make sure that NTFS for Mac and Paragon NFT for Macs and Kex load are all enabled. And we can finish the setup. And now we can mount and unmount from this application as well. And finally, after we've restarted for that time, as you can see in this top corner here, NTFS for Mac menu is here. And you see it has my drive, and I'm going to plug in my NTFS just to show you how it works. Now, just to be clear, this will only work with the drive of the company that you used to set it up. For example, if I use a Seagate drive now, I will not be able to use it. So if I go into the menu, so I've just plugged in my drive and it has appeared here. Nice and mounted. If I go to it, then I right click and put new folder. I can add any new folder, and if I want to add any files to it, so I'll just add the DMG for this, I can now add and delete files at will. Like I said before, if you do have just a MacBook, I highly recommend just formatting your hard drives to FAT32. But like I said, because I use this as a media tool as well and plug it into my Xbox, and Xbox only reads NFTS. And sometimes people like to, have Windows machines and Mac machines at the same time. I used to just run with two hard drives, and it was very, very annoying trying to move things between them. I had to load up my Windows machine just so that I could copy things over and then plug it into my Mac machine. I couldn't save any files while I was working on them. I had to drag them over to the desktop and then move them over to an FAT32. It's a very complicated process. I do like that this works. I do not like that you have to give it a lot of security privileges and extension kernels and things like that. But it's a very good system. Like I said, it's one of those things that is kind of annoying about having a MacBook and Windows. They have completely different file systems, which is why XFAT is the file system that I usually format. As you can see right here, I have over 3 terabytes of old files from my Windows machine that I need to sort through, and it would probably take a long time to go through it. So I just like to keep using this hard drive as it is. And that is, that's the solution, NTFS for Mac. This is the free solution. That's the free solution if you're lucky enough to own a Western Digital or a Seagate hard drive. And if not, I just recommend buying the Paragon software. It's $20, or in English, it's $20. It's $20, or if you're working in English pounds, it is only £18.90. So it's not really bad for a license that you're going to be able to use for the rest of your life. It is a perpetual single use license. There's no subscriptions or anything like that, which is something that I like about it, because I hate subscriptions these days. I just want to buy the apps that I use. It's one of the reasons I switched from DaVinci. It's one of the reasons I switched from Premiere Pro to DaVinci. And hopefully I'll be getting more videos out of this M3 Pro, mainly to do with emulation is usable. Also, I want to look at the game porting toolkit and things like that. So please like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. Take care, have a wonderful day. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.